Aloha! You can never get enough of saying that, right? How's everybody doing? You doing all right? Honey, we are a small but mighty crowd tonight, okay? Oh my goodness, thank you all so much for coming out tonight. Thank you, thank you. 62. Born in 1962. Turned 62, and I feel good. And I'm so happy to be here at ProArts. This show is my love letter to these artists. So I pick my favorite songs that these artists have recorded, and I tell my life story, but I just want you to know I might not get to your favorites tonight, but we're gonna have us a good time, okay? All right, well, so far, this is our second season. Last year, we had a great listing of artists. This year, I started the season off with Nina Simone. And then I'm going to be doing Ella Fitzgerald in November. Then we do Frank Sinatra in January. Whitney Houston in February. And then in April, we do Celine Dion. Okay, and then Earth, Wind, and Fire in May. And then we end the season with Nat King Cole and Natalie Cole. So plan to come back if you're visiting. We want to just thank you for choosing ProArts tonight. Okay, well, here's the deal. I don't do this show by myself. I always have a guest. And tonight is someone that I actually did the Marvin Gaye show with last year. And he was so much fun, I had to ask him back. Please put your hands together for R.E Metoyer. Say your last name.
Metoyer.
Metoyer, I did it right. Luther Ronzoni Vandross, okay? The voice, the velvet voice is what they called him. So I'm not gonna waste any more time. Bruce, let's do it, man! Hey, I want you to know you're allowed to clap your hands. You're allowed to sing. We want you to have a good time tonight, okay? Luther Ronzoni Vandross was born April 20th, 1951. He was born the youngest of four children in New York City, Manhattan, on the Lower East Side. And he always loved to sing. Now, his mother said he was a very reserved child. Hardly smiled, but one thing he wanted at all times was music, records, opportunities to go see music, opportunities to go play music, because he started playing piano when he was 3 years. Woo! Thank you myself, I don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my shining star, my guiding light, my love fantasy. There's not a minute, hour, day, or night that I don't love you. You're at the top of my list, cause I'm always thinking of you. I still remember in the days when I was scared to touch you, how I spent my daydreaming, planning how to say I love you. You must have known that I had feelings deep enough to swim in. That's when you opened up your heart and you told me to come in for my love. Thousand kisses from you is never too much, and I just don't wanna stop for my love. A million days in your arms is never too much, and I just don't wanna stop. Never too much. woke up today, looked at your picture just to get it started. I called you up, but you weren't there, and I was broken hearted. Hung up the phone, I can't be too late, the boss is so demanding. Opened the door up, and to my surprise, there you were standing. Who needs to go to work to hustle for another dollar? I'd rather be with you, cause you make my heart sing and holler. Love is a gamble, and I'm so glad that I am winning. We've come a long way, and yet this is only the beginning of my love. A thousand kisses from you is never too much. And I just don't want to stop. A million days in your arms is never too much. And I just don't wanna stop. Oh my love. A thousand kisses from you is never, 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 never. And I just don't wanna stop. This is a song that was written by Luther Vandross and his writing partners, Nat Adderley Jr. and the great bassist Marcus Miller. I speak to myself sometimes, and I say, oh my, in a lot of ways you're a lucky guy. Oh, all I need is a chance to try any love. Yeah. In my heart there's a need to shout, dying, screaming, crying, let me out. Yeah. For all those feelings that you wanna touch any love. Lonely guy. Sometimes I feel I'm gonna lose my mind. Can anybody tell me just where to find any love? You know, everyone needs a love, no doubt. Any love. Everybody without any love, any love. Well, I know there's a love waiting for me to come into my life. Yeah. Every day as I live, I try to think positive. I pray for someone else to give any love. Ooh, love is sweet and so divine, and I can't wait for my love light to shine. Can anybody tell me just where to find any love? You know, everyone needs a love, no doubt. Any love. Hey, everybody feels alone without any love. Baby, I know I love waiting for me come into my life, come into my life. Hey, suddenly out of the clear blue sky, lonely tears start to fill my eyes. I get weak, but I refuse to cry. I got to keep holding on. I got to be very strong. You were getting ready to hand me that towel. It won't be the same. It's all right. Thanks, Rob. Woo! You know, I knew when I put on all this hair, I was going to struggle. Thank you. Well, you know, if you ever see any concert, well, first of all, has anybody here ever been to a Luther Vandross concert? Okay, well, you know it was fabulous, that's right. Honey, you had to come with the sequins, you had to come with the glitter. Oh man, the big hair, honey. Yes, the big hair took me right back to the 80s. But actually, Luther had been making music for a long time before then. Again, I mentioned that as a child, he really loved music. His mother said that all he ever wanted for his birthday was albums and such. So his sister sang at the Apollo in a group called The Crest. And he went to the Apollo and he ended up joining a group called Listen, My Brother. It was a youth group, which I can relate to because I also grew up in a youth group that we used to go around and sing. But one of the great things that came from Luther being in this group was that they had open access to all of the acts at the Apollo. So he talks about this education that he got just watching all of the big name artists from that time that would go through there. So Luther, by the time he was 18 years old, he had written over 100 songs of his own music, just to tell you who he was. So this next song is one that was also written by Luther. And this is one that meant something to him because he would have people come up to him saying, you know, I didn't know how I was gonna leave that abusive situation I was in, but your song gave me strength. And that's the great thing about music. Love. What have you done, oh why? I was sure up till now that she was a friend. So I stayed till the end. I once believed that love was fair, but I don't anymore, she said. I'm a bore, and my heart hit the floor. Each time around, I tell myself it's the game of love. Ignore the signs and risk it all in the name of love. Ooh, yeah. I decided I won't let nobody hurt me again. So I say to the end, I just don't wanna be a fool. Said I don't wanna be a fool. Again, when ever a fool's in love, doesn't know he's to blame, he's caught in the game, and it all ends up the same. He looks at love in a different way. Breaks his heart every time they all turn out strange. But he'll never change. He's never gonna change. Oh yeah. Each time around, I tell myself it'll be better than before. I won't look back, there'll be no one tearing my heart out anymore. Ooh, yeah. I decided I can't let nobody fool me again. So I say to the end, I just don't wanna be a fool. Said I don't wanna be a fool. Never again. I said, no way. No, no, never. Can't be, no way. No way, no way. Ooh, I don't wanna be, I don't want to be a fool, no. I can't no more. Oh, it'll be alright. Cause I decided I can't let nobody kill me again. So I say to the end, I just don't wanna be a fool. And I don't wanna be a fool ever again. Can't be a fool. Can't be a fool. No, 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 never, no, never again. Can't be a fool.
To know this is true, because at the time I was singing with several corporate bands, party bands. Luther Vandross wrote two of the greatest wedding songs of all time. He wrote the second one he wrote for his niece's wedding. The first one he wrote just because he's a man that adored love. He adored telling stories about love. And I know for a fact I sang this next song probably at 100 weddings in the 80s, which I had no problem with. This is Here and Now.
Oh,
one look in your eyes, and there I see just what you mean to me. Here in my heart, I believe your love is all I'll ever be. Holding you close through the night, I need you, yeah. I look in your eyes, and there I see what happiness really means. The love that we share makes life so sweet. Together we'll always be. This pledge of love feels so right. I need you here and now. I promise to faithfully, you're all I need. Here and now, I vow to be one with thee. Yeah, yeah, your love is all I need. I need. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When I look in your eyes, there I see all that a love should really be. And I need you more and more each day. Nothing can take your love away more than I dare to dream. I need you, yeah, here and now. I promise to love faithfully. All I need here and now, oh, I bow to be one with thee. Yeah. You and me. Hey, yeah, your love is all I need. Starting here and oh, starting here, I'm starting right here, right now, because I believe in your love. So I gladly take a vow here and now. Oh, I promise to love faithfully. Yeah. Your love is all I need. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mm-hmm. Your love is all I need. Yeah, 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 yeah. Ooh, ooh. Hey, hey, yeah.
Yeah.
truly been good to me. Not even one sad day, a minute have I had since you come my way. I hope you know I'd gladly go anywhere you take me. It's so amazing to be loved. I follow you till the moon and the sky above. Ooh, I go. Got to tell you how you thrill me. I'm happy as I can be. You have come and it's changed my whole world. Bye-bye, sadness. Hello, Miller. What a wonderful day. It's so amazing to be loved. Hey, hey. Oh, yeah. Ooh, I go. And it's all amazing, amazing. Love brought us together. I will leave you never. Never without amazing love. Truly, it's amazing, amazing. Love brought us together. I will leave you never, no, never. Cause we got amazing love. Ooh, so amazing. And I've been waiting for a love like yours. It's so amazing to be loved. I follow you to the moon and the sky above. And you know it's so amazing to be loved. I follow you to the moon and the sky above. It's so amazing to be loved, yeah. You know it's so amazing to be loved. Hey, oh yeah. Oh, thank you so much. I gotta ask you a question. How many people here have ever seen the movie The Notebook? Round of applause, because I can't see you. I probably watched that movie about 20 times. Just a great love story for the ages, you know, about love that lasts a lifetime. So I asked you that question because in the movie, okay, the character Noah is Noah and Allie. And Allie, you know, when they're young, they go to this old, rundown, decrepit house and they kind of fantasize and visualize what they're going to do to this home when they get older. So when they end up separating because the family, you know what I mean? Her family didn't want her, you know, being involved with someone that didn't have means, laborer, whatever. But Noah builds this house up. I mean, he painstakingly just puts so much love into this house. And when it's time for him to sell it, he keeps finding all these reasons why, you know, he can't sell this house. You know, what, you're doubling the price? Get out of here, you must be crazy. You know, he comes up with all of these excuses. And I had to use that as an analogy because I think I did the same thing with this next song. this next song is a duet. And first of all, I never asked Ron if he wanted to sing it, okay? Then I knew I was being kind of shady, right? But I reached out to a couple of other male vocalists to sing this song with me, and you know, no matter what they did, for some reason, it just wasn't working out. You know, I'm like, you know, you said you were gonna call me back about 3 days ago. I don't think this is gonna work. Well, I finally realized it's because I've always wanted to sing this song solo, okay? I pulled a Noah, y'all! This is a song that was written by Marvin Gaye, and it was made famous by Marvin and Tammy. It was a huge hit for them. But Luther Vandross had an ability to take a song that someone else had written, to rearrange that sucker, I'm telling you. And what he and Sheryl Lynn did to this ballad was incredible. We are still singing it to this day, as opposed to the Marvin and Tammy version. That's what Luther did. Luther took their great song and made it even greater. This is If This World Were Mine. If this world were mine, I would place at your feet all that I own. You've been so good to me. If this world were mine, I'd give you the flowers, the birds, and the bees, and with your love beside me, it would be all I need. If this world were mine, I'd give you anything. If this world were mine, I would make you a king with wealth untold. You could have anything. If this world were mine, honey, just call me. Oh, baby, you are my consolation, and I feel so much sensation when you're in my arms. When you squeeze me the way that you do. You do, oh, the way that you love me. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Every sky would be blue long as you're loving me, baby. Life is so wonderful, my love. Whoa, give me pretty loving, baby. Give me pretty loving, honey. Keep on loving me. baby. Whoa, you know I need you, honey. You know I need you, baby. Keep on loving me, yeah. Loving me the way, the anytime you Bogart anything, we gonna call it, I did a Noah. So the fact is that we had been listening to Luther's voice over a decade before he put out Never Too Much. He is on so many, at least 50 national commercials that he not only sang on, and he didn't always sing on them, but he wrote them and he produced them. This man was making $600,000 a year in the mid-80s, okay? He was a millionaire before he put out his own record, his first record. His voice can be heard on other things, movies, and he was on the very first episode of Sesame Street with his group, Listen, My Brother. They were on the very first episode, October of 1969. So I wanted you guys to just sit back, relax. Angel's gonna dim the lights for you. And I want you to listen to these commercials and let me know if you remember them, okay? Here we go. Song was from The Wiz, the African-American adaptation of the popular story of The Wizard of Oz. And Luther Vandross wrote that song, Everybody Rejoice, which was the closing song once they killed the second witch, honey, at the end of the movie. That was it. You know, I wanted to end with that one because The Wiz had such a huge effect on the journey of my life, okay? Okay, first of all, when it came out, I was known as Little Stephanie Mills, honey, because I sang that song home everywhere. I sang it at every talent competition. I mentioned I was in a youth group. I used to go ahead and sing it for all the people. The very first Broadway show I ever saw that came to Denver, Colorado was The Wiz. I know because my mother said I couldn't go and I forged her name. I was determined to go to that show. And oh my gosh, it was so fabulous. And I had to wear this color because there's the scene where the people is like, you've got to be seen green to show that your style's laid. And if you're not seen green, you better be wearing jade. Okay. So here it is, this man, Luther Vandross. I didn't know he had this impact on my life from the time I was a teenager, but once again, I had been listening to him my whole, you know, aware not. Now, did you guys recognize some of those commercials? Isn't that something? We were listening to him, especially the one that stood out the most to me was the Juicy Fruit, right? Nothing like the flavor of juicy fruit gum. Come on. Nothing like the flavor of juicy fruit gum. That thing, we pulled that up from a drawer. We opened up a drawer in our brains. And that commercial has been sitting there. That's how long Luther Vandross was in our lives. So I mentioned that, you know, we had a lot of correlations, but this next song is one that he recorded, and it really meant something to me because in my choral group, I had a, well, I was in a group called Montage. And we were award-winning choral, madrigal group. Award-winning, yes, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so I can remember singing this song. And I can remember singing it at our program. And when I decided to add this as one of the Luther songs, it was amazing that those lyrics, maybe 50 years later, yeah, 50 years later, were still there. You know, so this is from Man of La Mancha, which they just played here at the MAC. Did anybody get a chance to see that? I heard it was fabulous. Well, I was going that Friday, but you know, the fire, there was a fire on the other side and the traffic was bad, so I missed it. But this is a song about Don Quixote and his quest. We'll see if you recognize it.
Heavenly cause, and I know
that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable, the unreachable, the unreachable Okay, I gotta know, am I the only person in here that has a loofah baby?
What's that? What is that?
Luther Vandross was definitely responsible for the population boom in the 80s, okay? I ain't gonna lie. Now, I was with somebody that really didn't have what they call now, he didn't have any game, okay? No conversation, you know, I liked him, yeah. But he didn't have to say much, because honey, he went on home and put that album on. And yes, I had a baby. This next song was one that was, it was written by Burt Bacharach and Hal David, recorded by Dionne Warwick. Now, Dionne is the woman that really, that light bulb moment for Luther, when he knew that he wanted to do what he was seeing on stage, where he always loved music. But when he saw Dionne Warwick sing, just the way she carried herself and, you know, these songs and the effect that she had on this audience, he knew in that moment that that's what he wanted to do. And so like he does, he took a song that Dionne had written, that, no, she didn't write it, but had recorded, and he flipped it and turned it. But in my research, I found out something. I think his inspiration really for the way that he end up arranging this song was Ella Fitzgerald's version. I want you, when you just think about it sometime, to go to YouTube and pull up Ella Fitzgerald's version of A House Is Not a Home. She laid that sucker back. And when I listen to her version and I listen to Dionne's version, I think, okay, this is where Luther, Nat Adderley Jr., and Marcus Miller, this is the version that they were listening to when they came up with this classic. This is A House Is Not a Home.
Mm-hmm.
do, do, do. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Still a chair, even when there's no one sitting there. But a chair is not a house, and a house is not a home when the two of us are far. When there's nothing there but gloom, but a room is not a house, and a house is not a home when the two of us are far apart and one of us. With me. Are you gonna be in love with me? It's driving me crazy to think that my baby wouldn't be still in love with me. Are you gonna be, say you're gonna be, are you gonna be, say you're gonna be, are you gonna be, say you're gonna be? Are you gonna be, say that you're gonna be, still in love with me? Great song. Written by two men. Come on up here, Ron. So I mentioned earlier about Luther. You know, he had his favorites because even that he was the first president of the Patti LaBelle and the Bluebell fan club, okay? He loved female vocalists, but again, his favorite all-time inspirational vocalist was Dionne Warwick. And so this next song is a dance party song that he wrote. And the more I listen to it, of course, when I'm preparing for the shows, I get kind of obsessive. And I probably watched about 20 documentaries. But in those documentaries, he kept describing the moment when he saw Dionne Warwick. So I'm convinced this song is not written for any lover. This song is written for Dionne Warwick. You guys, I'm gonna have a good time up here, so feel free to clap your hands, honey. Let's have some fun. Hit it, Bruce! Hey! Woo! Yeah! There he is. This song is called The Night I Fell in Love. Keep going over it again and again in my mind. I get these flashbacks and I feel so good. Hey, see, this is one night that I'll never forget. You know, it happened just like the movies. I mean, it actually happened just like this. Hey, hey, yeah. Stars were shining brighter than most of the time. Then love came out of nowhere. Yeah. No thrill will ever be like the night I fell in love. I tenderly remember the night I fell in love. It surely was the best thing to happen to my life. I fell in love. The stars were in your eyes. The night I fell in love with you. Yeah. I've been so many places, been to most parts of the world, yeah, and seen some things that have blown my mind, yeah, and nothing will ever be like. Hey, I tenderly remember, come on y'all, was the best thing that happened to my life. I fell in love. The starlights were in your eyes, yeah. Oh yeah, with you. Ding, ding, yeah. Come on, hey. Oh, Ron, what's up? Get a chance to talk to Ron here for a minute and kind of find out who he is and let him tell you a little bit about himself. How'd you get started in this business, Ron?
Ooh, well.
I went back too far.
You did. Playing Creedence Clearwater Revival in a garage on Elysian Fields Drive in Oakland.
We got some California folks in the house.
And then high school, you know, it started with the high school bands. I was playing high school dances when I was a freshman. And played football, but decided by the time I was a senior that I would rather play guitar than football. One career might be longer than the other.
Hey, that's a fact.
So I started playing the after parties for football games. And then, let's see, there was funk bands, there was rock bands. After high school, I was in a band called Rhythm Riot. We released an LP on Infrasonic Records in San Francisco. We were kind of a punk band, like kind of like nobody else. Okay. Kind of like Fishbone, but Fishbone was just getting started then. We're doing ska, funk, and reggae.
Okay.
And a couple of guys from University of California, Berkeley. And they were kind of politically minded, as you might think, and so it was pretty cool.
Okay.
But then, you know, I had written some stuff on that album, and I got a call to come here from a good buddy of mine that I had grown up with. And I said, well, let me finish painting this house so I can get enough money for an airplane ticket. I flew over here about a week later and started working the next day at a club in Lahaina called the Foxy Lady at the Royal Lahaina. I know some of you remember that place.
We got some folks went back in time.
We played from 11:30 to 4:30 in the morning.
Ooh, on Maui?
That's right. That's how it was back then.
Back in the day, that's how it was.
1983.
Wow.
And about 2 months into that gig, there was a young lady on the dance floor. It wasn't Luther, but it was Teddy Pendergrass.
Oh, Teddy Pendergrass.
So I went up to Disco Dave, the DJ, and said, Dave, put on Turn Out the Lights.
Turn out the lights.
That's the woman. And I asked her to dance. 40 years later, we're still married. So along the way, music's been good to me here on Maui. I've pretty much played all the time since then. I left for a little bit, went on tour with a Canadian artist. If any of you are from Canada, anyone from Canada?
That's a shock.
Yeah. I do a
Sunday. Oh, they went home.
They went home. Yeah, they'll be back soon, though. They'll be back soon. I played with a guy up there, and the band was called Street Heart. And you guys heard of Loverboy?
Yeah.
Well, those guys, the guitar player, the drummer, and the bass player came out of Street Heart. Street Heart had 5 platinum albums up there. So I had a blast, let's say, when I was in Canada. But I had a one-year-old back here. So I came back home, started working, opened up a record store.
Yeah.
Groove 2 Music in the Lahaina Cannery. It was a long story, ain't it?
You guys remember that, huh?
And there I met Bill Burton, who owned Sir Wilfred's, which I own now if you need some coffee.
nice and, little plug.
Yeah, Bill was the head of the Maui Jazz Society, which was before Bryant's Jazz Maui. And he used to come to me and always try to get me to close the store and go have a drink for lunch. Which I couldn't do because I was working by myself and I needed the money. But we got to be good friends, and I ended up running his stores for him and becoming the vice president of the Maui Jazz Society. And we put on a lot of shows. Bill talked me into a lot of things. Some things were good. We did. We started this event, which they were doing before what happened. It was called I Love Lahaina, and Bill and I started that, and it was a benefit for the West Maui schools. They had to participate, but all of them got money from it for just participating. And once we started it, Henry Capono wanted to come and play, Kaylee Rochelle wanted to come and play, and each year it got bigger and bigger, And it was great. Schools were making money. It was a blast. We did another show called the Front Street Jazz and Blues Walk, which was on Front Street during off-season when the Canadians went home. And you know, all the restaurants and everyone were a little slower. So we put bands, because you guys remember the Foxy Lady. You remember the 80s on Front Street. There was music all up and down the street. And so that was our intention, was to help the restaurants who were slow and to get all the musicians back on Front Street that used to do that. So we had 5 venues, I think, and they would each do 2 shows a day. And we did it Friday and Saturday and Sunday, then we had a main show in one venue. But it was great because all the guys from back then got to walk up and down the street like they used to in the 80s. And go see
and
their
hear
buddies.
Music in each of the venues.
Go hear their buddies playing down the street and then go back and play their set.
Well, tell me, what are you doing now?
Now I play every Sunday at Mulligan's on the Blue.
Island Soul Band.
And you can catch her with us.
This Sunday.
This matter of fact, this Sunday.
Celebrate, girl. I just got another reason.
Yeah, it's going to run through Sunday, I'm sure. And then I also have a blues band called the Blues Rock and Soul Review, and we will be here November 15th.
Put it on your calendar. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Ron Matoir. I did all right.
Yeah, you did. And a new single. There's a single out now.
Hey.
On all your streaming devices called Purgatory.
Ooh.
Call an emergency.
Okay.
And a new one will drop before we do that show.
On the 15th.
There you have it.
All right, support. You can sit right there. Yeah, come on, let's do this next song. Ready, Bruce? I wanna tell you, baby, the changes I've been going through. Missing you and listening to you, oh, till you come back to me. I don't know what I'm gonna do. No, 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 no. This is a song that was merged 2 songs. One that was written by Stevie Wonder for Aretha Franklin, Till You Come Back to Me, and Superstar, which was written by Leon Russell, made famous by the Carpenters. Beautiful ballad. Lots of babies were made to this song. I really do. window so far away. I fell in love with you. Before the second show, and your guitar, and you sound so sweet and clear, but you're not really here. It's just the radio. Don't you remember you told me you loved me, baby? You said you'd be coming back this way again, baby. Baby, 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 oh, baby. I love you, I really do.
To be yours,
yeah, yeah.
To be yours,
oh, 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 oh. Yeah, 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 yeah. You look for me to be yours, you're on the road, but you're all I want. Don't you remember me anymore? Loneliness is such a sad affair, sad affair. But I can hardly wait to be with you again. And no what to say, what to say, yeah, to make you come again. Come on back to me again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I wanna be anywhere you are. Don't you remember you told me you loved me, baby? You said I love you, yeah, I really do. It's alright, it's alright. Ooh, baby, it's alright, it's alright. It's alright now. Bring it back home, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's alright, it's alright. Ooh, baby, it's alright, it's alright. It's alright now. Ooh, keep it right there. Been right there, yeah, 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 yeah. It's alright. I wonder when I. when you're coming back, gonna hold me tight. Say, it's all right, it's all right. Ooh, baby, it's all right, yeah. It's all right. Ooh, honey, yeah. I wonder, wonder when can I hold you again, my love. I wonder, yeah, I wonder. Goodness, Luther! Oh man, I'm so glad you guys came out tonight. Thank you. This next song was the last hit for Luther. He recorded this song in 2003. And before the song was released, he had a massive stroke and was unconscious, was in a coma for 2 months. And he would spend the next 2 years fighting to get back. And I think about him writing this song. This is a song that he wrote for his father. His father died when he was 8 years old. And I had mentioned earlier that Luther was the baby, so you know them babies, honey. They get all the attention. So it was really hard for Luther, losing his father. It was very hard for him. His mother loved to dance, his father loved to dance, and they literally, when his mother was pregnant with him, she went into early labor because she was at the club dancing by 7-8 months. So dancing was a big thing in their family. And so Luther wrote this song for his father, and so we want to dedicate this to all the good fathers out there. I make that, you know, because not all of us were blessed with great fathers, I hate to say, but this song was hard for me to sing when it came out. It was really hard for me to sing it because I couldn't relate to it. And I know that there are a lot of people out there like myself, but you know what, I'm so happy for the people who have men in their lives who are just good men, good fathers to their children. So I got over myself and I'm gonna sing this for you guys. And we're gonna dedicate this to Ron's dad too, because Ron was, he let me know this one was gonna be hard for him. Yeah, because your dad, you, because of your dad or because of your son?
It's just a sad dang song.
Okay. All right, well, make me feel better than you. This was called Dance for My Father. Dance with My Father. Back when I was a child, before life would prove all innocence, my father would lift me high and dance with my mother and me, and then spin me around till I fell asleep. Then up the stairs he would carry me, and I knew for sure I was loved. If I could get another chance, another walk, another dance with him, I'd play a song that would never ever end. How I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Thank you. get my way, I would run from her to him. He'd make me laugh just to comfort me. Then finally make me do just what my mother said. Later that night when I was asleep, he left a dollar under my sheet. Never dreamed that he would be gone from me. If I could steal one final glance, one final step, one final dance with him, I'd play a song that would never ever end. 'Cause I love, love, love to dance with my father again. Sometimes I listen outside her door, and I hear how mama would cry for him. I prayed for her even more than me. I prayed for her even more than me. I know I'm praying for much too much, but could you bring back the only man she loved? I know you don't do it, you surely, but dear Lord, she's dying to dance with my father again. Every night I fall asleep, this is all I ever dream. Touching song. Did you guys have a good time tonight? It's so funny because, you know, the ticket sales were slow, and I was like, well, I wonder why, because don't people know who Luther Vandross is? So all I can say is, you guys get it. This man. Is my shoe okay? Okay. This man would go on to win 8 Grammys, okay? He would sell over 40 million records. 40 million records. He's in the R&B Hall of Fame. He has gotten so many accolades, including a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. He got his star. Of course, it was after he had passed, but this... They asked Luther how he wanted to be remembered. And he said he wanted to be remembered as one of the premier male vocalists of all times. And I think he did that. Okay. All righty then, Luther. He passed away. He had a heart attack on July 1st, 2005. And he left. He's gone, but his music is here forever. We're gonna end the night with one that was originally written by Sam Cooke, and once again, this fantastic songwriting team, Nat Adderley, Marcus Miller, and all the others who are part of it, because they're always others. You know, I can tell you as a session vocalist, you know, who add their flavor, but they took this song and did it up. So we're gonna party this last song, so this is all I can say. Y'all wanna dance with us? Anybody wanna come up here and dance? You wanna dance in your seat? Come on, hit it, bro! Scooby-dee-dooby-dee-dee-dee-dee. Well, all right. Scooby-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-d You can sing with me. Come on, y'all. Come on. Oh, yeah. Well, all right. Well, yeah. Throw back the rug, everybody. Move all the tables and chairs. We're gonna have us a good time tonight. Than getting together, yeah. The last time that we parked, come on y'all, come and join us. In it when the sun came up, that's when your mama told you that you couldn't go out, stay in the house. Ow! Oh, come on y'all, a bad boy. He's gonna sneak out tonight, yeah. He's gonna tip by her window, cause he sure wants to get out there. Everyone's here, then I'm all in. The chandelier downstairs has fallen. I know it's hard to resist. This is the party no one wanted to miss. If you don't get home on the double, you're going to be in trouble. In your room, cause if she does, she'll be here soon. Boy, he's gonna be bad, a bad boy. You got it, bad boy. Say goodbye to your friend, cause it's gonna be a while till you see them again. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Your bad boy, he's gonna sneak out tonight, yeah. He's gonna tip by her window, cause he sure wants to get out and dance, yeah. Come on, come on! Everybody sing, yeah. Dancing to the music on the radio. You can't go, ooh, you're bad boy. You're gonna sneak out tonight, yeah. Where you at, Dan? You're gonna sit by her window, cause it's your one to get out and dance, yeah. Everybody swinging, dancing to the music on the radio. Woo. Put your hands together for ProArts, y'all. Special thanks to Jazz Maui. Give it up for Ron, R.E. Metoyer. Hey, yeah, yeah. Woo! Thank you so much for coming out tonight and sharing Lucha with me. We gon' sneak out tonight. Yeah. Bad boy.